Welcome to day 270 of the 300 Movie Challenge. Today we watch the highest grossing film of November 2016, which was Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them.
I have a question.
Okay.
Am I stupid?
Why?
I had no idea what was going on.
Oh my god, okay.
The whole movie. Yeah.
Alright, cool. We're all on the same
Okay, just making sure, because I'm like, am I dumb? Like, what am I not getting this? I was literally having to look at the Wikipedia plot summary, like, the whole time, just to figure out what was happening.
And even then, it's, like, confusing, right?
Yeah.
Oh my, okay.
Because there is, like, three different plot lines going on and everything.
So I wasn't the only one feeling that way.
Okay. Good.
It's with Jay and all the confusing movies.
I don't even know where to begin because I'm still confused. I think now that I've, you know, gotten to the end and, like, read the plot summary, like, I understand what happened, but, like, not while watching it. I was very, it's just like,
okay.
Yeah.
I just want to, like, say this right now.
Okay.
This does not feel like it's connected to Harry Potter at all.
No, you're right. It doesn't.
That's probably what got me confused, because you have Harry Potter. It sets up the world. It's very concrete, at least, you know, with the few plot holes that do exist. It's concrete enough. People know it, like the back of their hand, like, you know, Potterheads know it like the back of their hand. I feel like they didn't use anything that was already established.
Or even then, well, they established a lot of new stuff, which you could think, okay, well, this could work in terms of expanding the world, but how they established it was like, it was like they established it assuming that you kind of already knew what they were talking about.
Yeah.
But we didn't.
Not only that, but I feel like it felt like, okay, let's take the wizards and everything and just set it in New York City and see what happens. Because I feel like the setting itself wasn't very, I don't know what the word is.
Not everything has to take place in New York City.
There's that, and then there's the fact that I feel like they didn't even use
They didn't that. Utilize it?
Yeah, they didn't utilize it either.
Yeah, because, right. Like, Hogwarts is such, like, an integral location to, like, everything that happens, right?
Yeah.
And, like, I at first I was like, okay, this is a noticeably different kind of environment. And I was kind of like, okay, this could be interesting, right?
Yeah.
But then they just kind of don't do anything with it. So,
no.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, let's go to all these locations in New York City and everything, but they don't really, there's nothing that says that this couldn't have taken place, like, in London, per se.
Right.
Yeah.
And everything. And if it did, maybe we could have even seen more with Hogwarts and stuff. Like, the only mentions that you get of things are, like, name drops, which is, like, you hear Dumbledore, you hear Hogwarts, everything.
I don't mind that. Like, if they are like, you know, here, it's in the world, but at least for right now, we are definitely telling our own story. That's fine, but, like, if it's your own story, you have to set up this new story. And I feel
exactly.
Like they don't. Yeah. Like, again, remember how for the first Harry Potter movie, we were like, this is really, really good character and setting setup.
Yeah.
Then this wasn't.
No.
So.
Yeah, I feel like a lot of assumptions were made. Like, maybe they assumed that we would, like, people who watched the movie would know whether they read, like, the Fantastic Beasts novella or, like, okay, I guess.
My knowledge with Fantastic Beasts is that it's just a book of all the creatures and animals.
Okay, it's not a story.
Not
a story. Yeah, okay. It's not a story. I don't think.
Okay.
I think the Wikipedia said it was inspired by, it's not like an adaptation of that book.
Okay, well, here's the other confusing thing then. Why did they name this movie that?
Yeah.
Because See, now they've kind of written themselves into a hole because, like, for example, the sequel's Fantastic Beasts, Crimes of Grindelwald, right? So,
yeah.
And apparently they're going to plan to do 5 of these. And so it's like, wait, so they're all going to be Fantastic Beasts somethings, but, like, now you're kind of stuck.
Will there be Fantastic Beasts?
Well, yeah, now you're kind of stuck with that moniker that, like, honestly didn't, I mean, it. I guess it had to do kind of with this movie, but honestly, in terms of the actual, like, plot, in terms of, like, what's different by the end of the movie, the beasts don't really have much to do with that.
No.
So, and I'll be honest, I just read the entire summary of, plot summary of Grindelwald, that movie, just because I was like, what happens? There's, like, no mention of beasts at all.
Oh my god.
Like, the characters are there, but, like, no beastie things, so... It's again, it's like a really weird thing where it's like, why didn't you just like name this something else? I mean, it obviously wouldn't be Harry Potter or something, but it could be, I don't know, something that like
Newt, what's his name or something. I don't is yeah. he the main character of the second movie too?
Yeah, it's kind of hard to tell, but
so just name it Newt. His name is an animal name. You're going for the same thing. It's probably short for Newton, but I don't know.
Doesn't say that, but whatever.
In any case, it's kind of just, yeah.
I'm really okay. Trying to think, like, how do I compare this to Goblet of Fire?
I don't know either, because at least with Goblet of Fire, while, like, the teenagers were acting like, you know, teenagers, at least we understood what was going on, even if we didn't love what was going on.
There were times when we were kind of like, wait, what's going on with connected? Confused. But, like, I think it was different, though, because, again, part of the issue, well, part of, I guess, the benefit of Goblet of Fire is that it was in the middle of a franchise, right?
Yeah.
We already knew like who the characters were. We already knew that Hogwarts was a thing and kind of what it does. So
yeah, you're confused by maybe the plot and the events, but the world still makes sense.
Yeah, well, and it would also be like,
characters,
if you
at least... They're doing very confusing things that don't make sense, but you know, it's not like you're just introduced to them.
They're not breaking the rules that the world set up.
Well, think
already.
Of it this way.
Yeah.
Just imagine that Goblet of Fire was the first Harry Potter film you saw.
Then that would be bad.
Right, that's kind of how this is.
Yeah.
So, and there is kind of like some sort of like a charm and stuff that kind of, for me, like kind of came through with Goblet of Fire that had just been there the whole time for the whole series, but this didn't have that.
I guess this is a good lead into the next thing we should probably talk about, which is the characters. I didn't feel any attachment to any of the characters except the guy who just wanted to start his bakery.
Yeah.
He was alright.
I identified the most with the baker guy.
Yeah.
And that's mostly because, like, it seemed like his role was kind of like the guy who doesn't know what's going on or whatever, right?
Exactly.
And it's like, yeah. Oh, hey, that's us. So.
Yeah, because, like, Newt is, like, he kind of plays off of, like, the aloof foreigner, and then his woman, I don't remember her name. I just remember her last name is Goldstein.
Yeah, Tina.
Tina. Mm-hmm. She's kind of just like the hard ass.
Well, she tries to be, but then you kind of are like, okay, I guess you got demoted and stuff like that. Mm-hmm.
And then her sister is kind of like the romantic ditz.
Yeah.
So, I mean, like, I like the baker to some extent. I wish I liked him more, because I feel like his type of character is one that I tend to like. It's just that it's hard when you're trying to also figure out, like, what's happening to him. I don't want to feel like him. I want to sympathize with him, but I want to know what's going on to be able to sympathize with him. Mm. You know what I mean?
Yeah. And then this whole other plot with, like, the teenage kid, I already forgot his name.
Cadence! That's the dumbest name ever heard.
It's just, that whole thing with him and, like, the guy who was apparently Grindelwald in disguise or something, and, like, that
was
just...
I was confused by that.
I had no idea what was going on with that plot, like, the whole time.
Okay, this is what, like, I... This is what I understand from the summary.
Okay.
He's, like, I guess kind of special, because I remember they were talking about how if you have the, like, gassy thing inside you, then you die before you hit age 10.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
But he has, like, the big gassy thing. I don't even remember what it's called anymore. He has the big...
Or something?
Okay,
something like that.
The obtuse angle.
Oh my god.
So the obtuse triangle is in him. But he's, like, obviously older than 10. And he mentioned something about that. And then, like, the mom is, like, racist, I guess?
Maybe, yeah, I don't know.
Like, in the very beginning when she was, like, speaking to the other muggles and, like, talking about, like, this, like, what, the Salem witch trials or something, I was like, oh, they're making a commentary on how, like, evangelical Christians are in America. That's, like, kind of interesting considering, like, the time frame and the environment. But it got kind of, like, too ridiculous at some point.
Yeah.
I was just like, okay, I know we have, like, crazy evangelical people here, but I don't think they're, like, that outright horrible to the kids that they chose to adopt.
And, like, I'm just still, like, confused, like...
How did that tie into everything else that was going on?
Right, yeah, so it seemed like, okay, so...
Everything else going on?
So, okay, I'm just trying to think of this from, like, character motivation perspective. Okay, so Grindelwald, like, I guess wanted that guy to go along with him just because he's powerful? I guess? But, like...
Sure.
But, yeah, and then the other guys, they just got roped into it because the whatever fucking... I don't remember what they called it, the Magic Congress or whatever. They were like...
Magic Congress?
This is something like that. They were like, oh, well, it was some beast thing that killed that other guy, so, like, you're the one with the beasts, which is like, wait, how did they even, like, know that?
Yeah.
So... Then he had to, like, prove it wasn't him. I don't know. Like, this is told. It's told so obtusely and just strangely.
The obtuse triangles.
Whatever. Shush.
In any case, actually, bring up another point. I found the Magic Congress thing and the Magic President thing kind of strange. Because I know they had, like, the Ministry of Magic and stuff, but they didn't call it, like, a Parliament of Magic.
I guess, like, the Ministry of Magic, the whole idea was, like, they were just a council of, like, people who oversaw the other wizards and witches.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Not, like, ruled over them.
Yeah, and
like, they have rules, but they're not treated as, like, laws.
Well, again, it goes back to what I said about, like, if this is a brand new thing and you need to, you know, set up some new organizations and new... people and new roles and that kind of stuff, and that's fine, but, like, set it up and not just be like, oh, this is a thing.
Yeah.
You know, so... Yeah. Like, I feel like... Yeah, I feel like this would be an okay movie, or okay to decent, maybe, if, like, this was, you know, the third movie or something.
Right,
but it's the first one, and so it's like, I mean... I can't really think of, like, too many things that are, like, flat-out bad in terms of, like, individual pieces, but the pieces just fit together really poorly.
Yeah, I guess I kind of view this as it's like, not a bad movie, but I don't really like it.
Yeah. Like, and this is, like, to me, this is a net... negative, but it's not, like, super negative.
Yeah.
But... I don't know, I expected more.
Yeah.
It was confusing to the point where it was frustrating at points.
Yeah.
I guess, also, we had just, like, in terms of, like, time scale and stuff, it has been a while since we watched the Harry Potter movies, but we've seen them pretty recently in the grand scheme of things, too.
Yeah. And I do remember, like, several of the conventions of, like, the original ministry and all that stuff set in England and UK and stuff, but actually, it seems all of Europe, by what Newt says?
I don't know.
See? If they actually explained this shit in this movie, then we wouldn't have these problems.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I feel like if they started the series, like, say this was the second movie. The first movie maybe should have been, like, how Newt grew up and how he became, like, this traveler and everything.
Yeah.
And that would have dealt with, like, the ministry of, like, how things are set up, because he travels, too, so we would have seen how all the other places would have been and everything.
Either that, or have a story maybe centered on, like, Tina and, like, in New York City, just kind of, like, right. Doing stuff with that, you know, that group, so we understand how they work
first. Yeah.
Yeah, wait, actually, does the second Fantastic Beasts take place in America?
It apparently takes place in, like, America and, like, London and Paris and, like, Austria and, like, all over the place. What? So, yeah.
I'm preparing myself to become more confused then.
So, wait, but we're not watching it, right?
No, we're not, actually.
Oh, yeah, we're not. Okay, never mind. I guess I don't ever have to get confused then.
Yeah. I looked it up just because I was curious to see if they actually, like, do anything. But again, reading a Wikipedia plot summary is not the same as watching a movie, but I'll admit it doesn't exactly seem to make a lot more sense.
And it's supposed to just be a summary of the extremely important parts.
Yeah, so, like, you know how Credence is, like, he's totally, like, gone or whatever, right? And that whole thing was dealt with?
Yeah.
He's not.
Good.
So apparently he's, like, still alive and he's, like, a big focus of the thing and they, like, I don't know. Yeah, it's... I don't get it. It's confusing.
So that's what they were setting up with that?
I guess. I don't know.
I'm so fucking confused, man!
Great.
I think J.K. Rowling needs to actually write a book first.
Yeah.
And then yeah, get to make the movie.
I don't think screenplay is her strong suit.
No. I mean, wait.
Like, Cursed Child, too.
Well, yeah, I was about to say, isn't that kind of what how Cursed Child was? It wasn't a screenplay, but it was, you know, same kind
of thing. From what I understand, like, she approved of the idea, but other people wrote it. But from what I understand right now, the Harry Potter fandom is just like, we don't want any more things.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah.
I mean, I totally understand, because, like, their franchise ended just fine with Deathly Hallows. It was, like, done, Pottermore came out, everyone was happy, and then...
Duff.
Yeah, it didn't die yet.
Please just let good things end. I know that people are always complaining, oh, we want more, and it's like, if you get to an end, stop.
Yep.
So.
And try something else, or if she wants to still use the universe and stuff, then again, just sit down and write a book first.
Yeah, because that requires a bit more, like, editing, and well, maybe not all the time, there are a lot of bad books out there, but I imagine that maybe she's probably better with prose and not dialogue.
And probably the time frame is different, I'm sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that's probably a big factor as well. Well, this year started off, like, really strong with, like, the first half, and now it's just kind of not been that great.
No.
it's just like watching something slowly die.
It's a slow burn instead of a kabam.
Yeah. I mean, it was better than Suicide Squad.
high bar, but
not a high bar to clear. Well, we got one more for this year. It's yeah, this coming up is an interesting movie just in concept, and one that people have interesting feelings about. So
I'm
pretty sure you guys can already guess what it is, but
yeah, it's, you know, the biggest franchise ever, so
but yeah, so that's next, and be curious to see what you two think about it.
Okay.
So that's that, I guess. What's also weird to think about is that with this movie, we are now officially 90% done.
Oh, it's true.
Which is just,
oh my god,
really weird to think about. But
yeah,
yeah. Considering how, like, a year ago we were still in the 90s.
Were we?
I think so. Because we had just picked up. Or no, wait. For some reason, I thought we were in November, and then I remembered we're in February.
Yeah, it's February 2019 right now.
No, it's March 2019.
Oh yeah, it's March 1st. Oh, yeah. Oh, right, shit.
Guys!
I'm not paying attention.
I'm tired.
We're all tired, but yeah, I'm trying to, where were we like a year ago? I don't even remember. Actually, what? were we like 2003, like right now?
Maybe?
Oh, we were suffering.
We maybe.
Wait.
Something like that. Anyway, whatever. But next time is the thing. So, there you go.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.